Railgun could soon become reality, and Japan is taking lead in this technology. Japan's Acquisition, Technology and Logistics Agency, ATLA, has unveiled new images from tests of a prototype electromagnetic railgun conducted earlier this year aboard the experimental warship JS Asuka. While the U.S. Navy shelved its railgun program in the early 2020s due to major technological challenges, Japan has continued to advance the weapon's development, seeing promise in its long-term potential. The JS Asuka, a unique 6,200-ton displacement test platform operated by the Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force, JMSDF, was first observed carrying the railgun in April when it was mounted in a turret on the ship's stern flight deck. Subsequent imagery confirmed the configuration and highlighted Japan's steady progress in this field. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how Japan's railgun is set to disrupt naval warfare. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Acquisition, Technology and Logistics Agency's official Instagram page stated, ATLA conducted the shipboard railgun shooting test from June to early July this year with the support of the Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force. It's the first time that a ship-mounted railgun was successfully fired at a real ship. One of the images shared by ATLA on Instagram and reposted across its other social media platforms shows the railgun in the act of firing. In the same frame, what appears to be a radar array along with an electro-optical and/or infrared camera system can be seen mounted on a separate turret. Another photograph shows a tug-like vessel framed in the crosshairs of a targeting system. Additional views of this vessel reveal target boards mounted on both sides of its funnel and another positioned on the stern. However, ATLA has not yet released any visuals confirming successful projectile impacts on target ships. The agency has indicated that further details will be disclosed at its Defense Technology Symposium in November. Railguns are electromagnetic devices designed to launch projectiles at hypersonic velocities, relying on electromagnets rather than chemical propellants to fire their projectiles at very high velocities. The railgun's operation hinges on electromagnetic principles, specifically the Lorentz force, which arises when a current-carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field. The key components include rails, armature, and power supply. The two parallel conductive rails, usually made of copper, act as the barrel. These rails are connected at the breech rear to the power supply and extend to the muzzle front where the projectile exits. Armature is the conductive component, such as a solid metal slug, sabot, or plasma, that completes the electrical circuit between the rails. The projectile is often integrated into or carried by the armature. Power supply is designed to supply enormous electrical energy. It often uses capacitors or pulse generators capable of supplying currents in the millions of amperes for milliseconds. Magnetic field strengths typically reach approximately 10 Tesla. The current generates a magnetic field around the rails perpendicular to the current flow as per Ampere's law. This force accelerates the armature and projectile along the rails toward the muzzle, achieving velocities around 2,000 to 3,500 meters per second, Mach 6 to 10. ALTA reported that its prototype achieved muzzle velocities exceeding 2,500 meters per second, compared to 1,750 meters per second for tank guns. The shells are not full of explosives, but do damage by transferring kinetic energy. It is believed that an optimized railgun could hit targets 100 miles or 160 kilometers away due to flat trajectories and high velocities. To give viewers a perspective, the 5-inch Mark 45 Mod 4 gun installed on the U.S. Navy Arleigh Burke-class destroyer has a range of 23 miles or 37 kilometers. Developing railgun is very complex. For example, from 2005 until 2022, the U.S. Navy pursued a similar program only to suspend it after encountering persistent technical hurdles and repeated delays in sea trials. ATLA has been pursuing railgun technology since the mid-2000s, conducting multiple land-based test firings along the way. Together with the Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force, the agency is aiming to develop an operational system that could eventually be fielded on frontline warships. In 2023, ATLA announced it had achieved the world's first successful firing of a railgun from a ship, though the specific vessel involved was not identified. The agency has also released concept renderings showing railguns installed on the future 13 DDX destroyer, as well as on existing Maya-class 27 DDG destroyers. Japan's Ministry of Defense has similarly displayed a model featuring a railgun in a sleeker, more compact turret design compared to the bulkier prototype seen on Asuka. At the DSEI Japan 2025 exposition earlier this year, Kazumi Ito, principal director of ATLA's Equipment Policy Division, noted through an interpreter that the program is progressing, while also conceding that various challenges remain, according to National Defense Magazine. A fully operational electromagnetic railgun would represent a transformative addition to naval and joint force firepower. The projectiles themselves are compact, solid metal rounds, far less expensive to produce than guided missiles or even advanced shells, allowing warships to carry deeper magazines and sustain high rates of fire at a fraction of the cost per shot. This cost-effectiveness is particularly attractive in the maritime domain, where space for vertical launch cells is limited and at sea resupply of missiles remains a major logistical challenge. A railgun battery could provide layered defense and offensive capability, firing in volume against incoming aircraft, drones, or cruise missiles, while also striking surface vessels or even land-based targets. In essence, it offers warships a multi-mission weapon system that combines the economy of traditional naval guns with the extended reach and precision effects more often associated with missile arsenals. Japan's pursuit of this technology aligns with its broader modernization agenda, which includes hypersonic missile development, expanded missile defense capabilities, and next-generation destroyer designs. Taken together, these efforts reflect Tokyo's response to a deteriorating security environment, marked by North Korea's advancing missile arsenal, China's naval expansion and assertive activities in the East China Sea, and Russia's increasingly unpredictable behavior in the Pacific. By continuing to push railgun development where other countries, notably the United States, have slowed or halted their programs, Japan positions itself at the forefront of a technology that, if realized, could significantly reshape future naval warfare.